So hey guys, this is Deepak here and welcome to the Digital Marketing Masterclass. Today we are going to talk about how to generate traffic to your websites, and we are going to talk about everything in digital marketing. So usually in most of my masterclasses, I go ahead and share a slide deck or a presentation. But today, instead of sharing a slide deck or a presentation, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to go ahead and show you behind the scenes of my business. I'm going to show you some tools which I use. I'm going to show you how I set up Facebook ads and Google ads, how I manage my landing pages, and basically the entire funnel which is behind the scenes of my business. So I hope you are excited about today's class, and I hope you want to learn more when it comes to digital marketing. So just type LM in the chat box if you are excited and if you want to learn more. Just type LM in the chat box. All right, fantastic. So I see there are 2,100 people live in today's class already. And maybe because it's a weekend, we are not having 3,000 as we usually have. This also means that I will be able to go ahead and answer some of your questions, and I will be able to focus on them. So I am going to go ahead and share a blueprint right now. And this is a blueprint which will help you go ahead and learn how to do integrated digital marketing and learn how to drive traffic. So I'm going to explain this blueprint for the first 5-10 minutes. And after that, we will get into the actual classes. All right. So here we are. And this is the blueprint, right? So what we are going to do is that we are going to analyze this blueprint. I hope everybody is able to see my screen clearly. Just type clear in the chat box if you are able to see it clearly. Fantastic. All right. So now I'm going to go ahead and close the chat for a while because it might be distracting for you. All right. And then I will open up chat again when I want to ask for your feedback. So what is the high traffic blueprint? And this is a blueprint that I created earlier. I used to call it the integrated digital marketing blueprint, but then I thought high traffic is a better way to call it because it's short and sweet. And it's also the brand name that I'm going to go with, which is called high traffic. So what we are basically looking at here is that, in most of the cases, when you look at a lot of agencies, a lot of digital marketers, these digital marketers and agencies go ahead and approach the business in such a way that they are going to take one channel of advertising, which is going to be either Facebook ads or Google ads, or it could be social media, or it could be SEO. And then they try to get results just based on that particular, that particular channel. And what happens is that when they just go ahead and follow one particular channel of, advertising to try to, get traffic, then it usually does not work. And when you look at the advertising agencies that are out there in the world, and you might have heard about a lot of advertising agencies. So all the advertising agencies have a big problem. Earlier, what happened was that when you had an advertising agency, they used to advertise on TV, radio, newspapers, and sometimes magazines. And what they used to do is that they would just treat it as a billboard. They would create an ad. They will come up with an ad creative, and they will just distribute across all these platforms. But one of the biggest problems with traditional media advertising is that traditional media advertising is one way. It is not interactive. It's not a two-way communication. So here in digital marketing, what we have is that we have a two-way communication channel. I'm communicating to you and you are communicating to me. And we always have an interaction. So that is what a lot of digital marketing agencies out there who are traditional digital marketing agencies, who used to be traditional advertising agencies, are now doing digital. They are just treating the internet as a big billboard, right? They are just looking at different channels like they used to look at TV, radio, newspapers, and magazines. And sometimes, outside hoardings and billboards that are out there. So what they did was that, when the digital came along, they just created a digital link, and they went ahead and said that, hey, if you want to go ahead and run video ads, you can run it on TV, but you can also run it on YouTube. Then they went ahead and, created, probably something like podcast ads, which was like equivalent of radio ads. And then instead of advertising on newspapers, they created banner ads. And we all know that banner ads do not have much click-through. Do you know what is the click-through rate of banner ads? The click-through rate of banner ads is as low as 0.1%, which means that out of 1,000 impressions, only 1% is going to click on a banner ad. And when was the last time that you clicked on a banner ad? You know, we usually ignore the ads and we have something called ad blindness where we don't look at the ad at all. And when there is a banner ad, we just ignore it, right? You know, that is what happens when it comes to, you know, banner ads. So banner ads are really not a good way to advertise. So I would not recommend banner ads at all. So when you look at, for retargeting, it's fine, but not to try to get, you know, a brand new traffic, right? So that's what usually happens. So what is the high traffic blueprint and why is it different from the traditional approach that digital marketing agencies and companies take? So digital marketing agencies and companies go ahead and treat this entire different channels of advertising like, okay, SEO hey, just let's just try to, you know, rank on SEO. Okay, there is social media, let's just go keep posting on social media and create content on social media itself. And then they look at email marketing, they try to buy an email database, they just try to upload the email database into a email marketing tool, and then they try to send out emails and then they expect sales directly. Then they use Facebook ads and Google ads directly. But all this does not work, right? Because the efficiency of all this is like very, very less. So what I have done is that I have created this blueprint and I have created this structure. And what we are having in this structure is that we are having content marketing in the center. So basically what we have is that we are going to start with blogging and content marketing, and we are going to publish content on our YouTube channel and whatever it is. So, you know, without great content, nobody is going to pay you attention, right? I hope you are going to agree with that. So right now we have 2,200 people live watching this webinar right now. And why do you think that there is such a huge audience watching this webinar right now? There is a huge audience watching this webinar right now because I hope I am giving you good content. And without good content, nobody is going to pay you attention. Content is the center of everything. Without content, everything will fail. Agreed? So we first start with content, and that is why I have put content in the center. And what do we do next? Once we have deployed content, what do we do next? We go ahead and create a lead magnet. And once we create a lead magnet, which is basically like a free course or an ebook or whatever, which is to capture email IDs. So once we create like a lead magnet, we are going to go ahead and, you know, have email marketing involved in the entire mix. So we have to start building our email list, right? And what we can do is that once we have created a piece of content, so let's say you have created a blog post and you are posting this blog post on social media. And let's say you have a LinkedIn network, let's say you have a Facebook network, let's say you have a Twitter network. What will happen is that, let's say you have 500 connections on LinkedIn. You create a blog post, you put it on social media, and do you think that maybe 10 people out of those 500 people will come back and visit your blog? Probably yes. And once they come back and visit your blog, what they will do? They will go ahead and sign up for your email list, because in the email list you can say that, hey, subscribe to my blog to get more updates, or go ahead and download this particular ebook or something like that, you will say. So when you go ahead and say something like that, then what happens is that the email marketing and social media starts working around the content and it starts feeding each other, because you create a new piece of content, you share it on social media, and people from new people from social media from your network come back to your content. If some of the people from the social media network come to your content and if they like it, they will share it on social media again, which will go ahead and spread the content to their network, and more people will start coming back. Now with all these visitors, what you can do, you can go ahead and start building your email list. And your email list is basically something where you are going to go ahead and start having more and more people on your email list. And once you have more people on your email list, let's say you publish the second piece of content. And when you publish the second piece of content, you can go ahead and send out a mail to the entire list, right? So imagine that you have 500 people on your email list. You have published a new blog post. Now you can send out a mail to the entire email list saying that, hey, check this out. I have published a new blog post. Why don't you go ahead and read this blog post? So what will happen is that people will come to your blog post. If they like it, they will share it on social media. And then this entire engine will start. Now we have not even talked about other areas of the entire funnel, right? We have just talked about email marketing, content marketing, and social media. This is how these three things will fit together. But what will happen is that search engines will also look at the kind of traction that you are already getting for your blog. And once you get your blog, you know, up and running, like for example, in my internship program, in the week four of my internship program, all my interns do an assignment of creating their own website, and they also go and get their website indexed. So once you create a website and once you get your website indexed on the search engines, I will also show you some of the tricks which you can use to go ahead and get your website indexed on the search engines. So what will happen is that let's assume that there are some people coming from the search engines to your content. And what will happen is that once they come from search engines to the content, you can start building your email list. You can start building your email list. You can use tools like Opt-in Chat. So Opt-in Chat is one of the tools that I have developed. And basically what will happen is that Opt-in Chat will show you a pop-up, and in the pop-up you can go ahead and enter your name and email ID and it will capture it. So now you have, let's say, a bunch of visitors coming from SEO. They come to your content, people like it, then the search engines pick up the signals, search engines will start sending you more traffic. This will start building your email list even more, and this will go ahead and build your social media following even more. So now we see that there are four components we have talked about: email marketing, content marketing, SEO, social media. And you see everything starts working in a way that everything complements each other. Everything starts, you know, boosting the effect of, you know, other channels. And now we have only paid advertising and sales and conversion remaining. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to open up the chat and you can let me know. Just, you know, let me know, maybe just say, wow, if this whole concept was like, wow, and it kind of, you know, gave you some clarity on how digital marketing will work, just put wow in the chat box and, you know, let me know kind of, you know, some feedback on what you feel about it. So you see that the approach that I take for digital marketing is a little bit different, right? Is it different? And you might not have seen this approach anywhere else. And this is what I call the high traffic blueprint. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to now talk about paid advertising and sales and conversion as well. So now let's go ahead and talk about paid advertising and sales and conversion. And I will just close the chat until then. So what about paid advertising and sales and conversion? So a lot of people, what they do, they go ahead and you know, run Facebook ads. They go ahead and run Google ads. They spend money on Facebook and Google. And what they will do is that they will go ahead and you know, advertise their products and services, and then they expect their products and services should start selling immediately. No, it's not like, you know, do you think that you can go out on a date and in the very first date, can you ask a woman to marry you if you are a man? And if you are a woman, what if a man asks you to, you know, asks for your hand in marriage in the very first date? You know, you will freak out, right? If you're a woman, and if you're a man, then you will probably get a slap in the face or something like that, right? So what happens is that you cannot go ahead and ask for a big commitment without building the relationship first. And this is the exact same mistake that everybody is doing with paid advertising. It's like, you know, even if you go down, drive down a Mercedes-Benz, if you are wearing like an Armani suit and Gucci shoes, and if you are going ahead and telling them, hey, will you marry me? Then nobody is going to say yes, because the trust is not built. And this is exactly what businesses are doing. Businesses are going ahead and trying to get sales of their products, which is a big commitment, without even building relationship with these people in the first place, right? So when I run paid advertising campaigns, I do not run paid advertising campaigns for my products directly. That will not work. Unless the products is like extremely cheap, I will not go and run paid advertising for that. Excuse me. So instead, what I do is that I run paid advertising to boost my content, and I also run paid advertising to go ahead and get more email subscribers. So I directly drive traffic to my email marketing landing page, and I start getting more subscribers. So once I start getting more subscribers, then I can deliver a lead magnet to them. And once I deliver a lead magnet to them, I can go ahead and kind of push them into content. And then once I push them into content, my SEO strategy goes up, and then my social media strategy also goes up, right? So what will happen is that instead of taking traffic from paid advertising and putting it on sales and conversion directly, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to put it on my email marketing, put it to my content, give some free content and free value first. Like right now, I'm giving free value, right? I'm teaching all this for free. And I ran paid advertising campaigns to build my email list. And I'm not even, you know, right now selling you anything, right? I'm providing value. And I'm building trust with you. Do you think that you trust me more because I know I'm providing a lot of value, I'm providing a lot of content? So this is how the entire funnel works. And then you only sell from your email marketing and content marketing. Only when you are delivering content and value, you go ahead and do the sales and conversion. That is how you go and sell and convert. You don't try to take people directly from paid advertising to go and do the sales and conversion, which is the mistake that most of the people in the world are doing. Right? So now I will open up the chat and let me know what you think about the high traffic blueprint. Just type high traffic in the chat box if you think that, you know, this entire blueprint is, you know, very clear for you. So just type high traffic. All right. So what will happen is that if you do all this, you can generate high traffic to your websites, right? You can generate high traffic to your websites if you do all this. Now, do you want to save this image? Do you want to save this image, guys? Yes. This blueprint you want. So what I have done is that I have posted this blueprint on my Twitter account. And I will go ahead and share this link with you on the chat box. And you can go ahead and just retweet it. You can just go and comment on it. I would like to get your comments about what you think about the high traffic blueprint. So you can retweet this particular tweet and you can leave a comment here about what you think about this entire blueprint. Now that I have explained it to you, in the next section of this webinar, I will go and show you behind the scenes of my email marketing funnel, my content marketing, everything I will show you. So go ahead and retweet, go ahead and like. So let's see what kind of activity we are getting here. So we have 162 retweets, 245 likes, and we are looking at a lot of people putting it on the comments. So if you have a Twitter account, go ahead and retweet it for me. So now that we have had a look, so you can also save this image from Twitter. You can just open the image and save it for yourself so that you have the high traffic blueprint with you. All right. So clear, guys. Until now, it is clear. Just type clear in the chat box if it is clear for you so that we can move on to the next section of the webinar. Fantastic. So people who want to join the internship program batch 6, I hope you now you are getting some confidence about the kind of approach I take with digital marketing and the kind of things that you are going to learn. Yes. Fantastic. Cool. So now let's go ahead and have a look at, you know, some of the behind the scenes stuff. So I talked about content marketing, right? So first let's have a look at, you know, some of the content that I have and what is my content strategy. So I will show you my content strategy. Let's have a look at, so some people are saying, Deepak, since you changed your camera gear. Yes, I got a new camera. All right, so now let's have a look at my content strategy. What have I been doing with content? All right, so let me share my screen right now. So first, I always go ahead and start with content because content is the best way to go ahead and start getting some traction in the web, right? If you don't write, then you are not going to have a lot of traffic coming to you. You need to have a lot of traffic coming to you. And this traffic is very important because that is the starting point of everything. With content, you are getting the traffic. And once you start getting the traffic, that is when the entire engine of the high traffic starts, right? So you have digital freelancing, 7 ways to fire your boss in 2020. This is the recent content that I have written. And I wrote this article in 5 hours continuously, which is 4,300 words. All right. So how many of you have read this article? Have you read this article? So this is the kind of long form content that I write. You know, long form content I write because that's what, you know, gets the traction. If you have not read the article, I will share the link with you on the chat box, and you can go and visit the article. So we will have a look at what is the kind of traffic that this particular article has got. So I will go ahead and show you Google Analytics, right? So the people who are in my internship program, as part of the assignment, they go ahead and install Analytics on their website, and they start getting traffic to their website and start tracking it. So for people who do not know about Analytics, I will go ahead and show you what is real-time statistics. So this is the amount of traffic that I am getting to my website right now in real time. So if you go ahead and visit that website, you will be able to see that the count here will go up. So right now we have 216 people live on the site. And here you can see that digital freelancing is where most of the people are visiting. And if you want to go ahead and check out the locations, you can click on locations. Click on India. And here you will be able to see the top cities where people are visiting from. So it looks like Pune is the number one city. In my audience, I think Pune is the largest group where people are coming from, right? So then we have Pune, Mumbai, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Kolkata, Chennai, Lucknow. And if you want Mumbai to come on the top, Mumbai users, go and visit the site. Let's see if Mumbai comes on top. And usually Bangalore is the first. My city is Bangalore, though I am right now at Salem at my parents' house. Bangalore is usually the biggest audience that we have. Looks like Pune is still in first. So if you want to kind of create a leaderboard. So now we have 325 visitors who are live on the site right now. It has just got to 363. And this is how you track, track the amount of visitors that is coming to the site. So right now we have Mumbai on the first. So Mumbai people, kudos to you. Mumbai is first, and then Pune second, and Bangalore third. So here you can see that, this is the distribution of traffic. You have Delhi 18 users, Lucknow 15 users, Patna, Kolkata. Then we have Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Pune. We have Hyderabad, we have Bangalore, and we have Chennai. Right? This is how live tracking works. So how many of you think that, tracking visitors live is amazing? Just type wow in the chat box if you think that tracking visitors live is amazing. Right? So, this is a free tool. If you go ahead and set up a blog for yourself, you will be able to track all this. And if I go into audience, then I will be able to see the amount of visitors that is coming to my site every day. So here you can see, this is the amount of visitors that is coming to my site every day. And I can go ahead and check the traffic right from June 1st and click on apply. So here you can see that in the past 3 months, we have had 136,000 users come to digitaldeepak.com, 229,000 sessions. And the average session duration is 3 minutes, and bounce rate is 68%. So these are the statistics that you can see. You can track the daily traffic that is coming to the site. And if I go into acquisition, you will be able to see the amount of traffic coming from different sources. All right. So what are the different sources of traffic? So here we can look, direct traffic is 48% direct traffic. So this is the direct traffic which you are visiting directly. So if you go ahead and visit the site directly, then this is direct traffic. Then you have organic search, and then you have paid search. So organic search is where we have 24% of the visitors are coming to organic search. So how to see it for your website? You have to install Google Analytics. And then we have paid search, which is 23,000 visitors. And this is the distribution for the entire traffic. So this is how you track visitors. So all this is covered in my Google Analytics course. So how many of you here have my Google Analytics course? Let me know in the chat box. Just type me in the chat box if you already have my Google Analytics course. So in my Google Analytics course, I have, analyzed, all this in depth. It's like a course with almost like, 15, 20 videos. And this is where I go ahead and teach analytics for you. So, you go ahead and publish content, and content can be published on the blog. You can also go ahead and publish content on your YouTube channel for your content strategy. So this is my YouTube channel. I have 88,874 subscribers right now. So if you are not subscribed to my YouTube channel, do you want to go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel right now? So my YouTube channel has a lot of videos, and each and every video is very, very in-depth, and you will be able to go ahead and get a lot of insights from it. So I post a lot of these videos. Even this webinar's recording will be shared on my YouTube channel. So I'm going to get 100,000 users soon and 100,000 subscribers. So I hope you have subscribed to my YouTube channel. And recently I even created a video called the Master's Blueprint. And this is something that I posted today morning. So what I do is that once I publish content on my YouTube channel, so let's have a look at 8874. And if you go and subscribe right now, you will see that we have increased in the number of subscribers. Go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want to get more. Guys, is it cool that if I share my YouTube channels and stuff like that, is it cool? Just type cool in the chat box if it's cool. All right. I hope you are also learning a lot in the process. Fantastic. So pretty much everybody is saying it's cool. So why not? Why not? I have you guys live here, and I might as well go ahead and get you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will share all the links in the email. So now what I do is that whenever I publish a new video, I also go ahead and send out an email. Like, for example, recently I went ahead and wrote a 4,300 word article in 5 hours. And this is a video which goes for 5 hours. I sent out an email to the entire email list. And when I sent out an email to the entire email list, I got 3,661 people who have viewed this particular video. And most of these views have come from my email marketing, not just YouTube subscribers. So what happens with social media is that sometimes the algorithm of the YouTube, you know, social media in YouTube has a problem, right? What they will do is that they will not help you get the reach. And if you don't have the reach, then you will not be able to go ahead and, you know, have a proper promotion, right? You know, we will not be able to promote your content. So the best way to go ahead and promote your content is that you go ahead and publish it on your YouTube channel, and also send it to your email list, because your email list becomes your asset. Without your email list, you do not have anything, right? Your email list becomes your asset. And now we will talk about the strategy for search engines. So, you know, here you can see that this is Search Console. So how many of you know about Google Search Console? Type yes in the chat box if you know about Google Search Console, and if you don't know about Google Search Console, type no. All right, so looks like a lot of people don't know about Google Search Console, and this is also something that in my internship program I explain in depth, and I also explain it in my SEO Mastery course, which is part of my course bundle. And here I will just give you an overview of what is Google Search Console. So Google Search Console is basically going to help you track the amount of visitors that is coming from the Google search engine. Google Analytics will go ahead and show you all the stats in terms of traffic happening on your site. But Google Search Console will also show you what is happening on the search. Like, for example, if I go into search results, you can see that in the past 3 months, let's say last 12 months, okay? Let's look at last 12 months. You can see that in the last 12 months, we have got 8.16 million impressions, and we have got 1,93,000 clicks. So if I paid 10 rupees for each and every click, how much is the total amount the traffic is worth? Let me know in the chat box. How much is the traffic worth if I pay 10 rupees for each and every click? Because let's say the each and every click is worth 10 rupees. So yes, it's 19.3 lakhs worth. This is not paid traffic. This is free search traffic that I'm getting to my site when people are going ahead and searching for different keywords. Like, for example, when people search for MBA in digital marketing, my site is showing up. You can see 1,143 clicks that has come to my site. Digital Deepak course, Digital Deepak.com, Digital Deepak internship. So right now, Digital Deepak internship is one of the most searched keywords. If you go ahead and search for Digital Deepak internship, then you will be able to see that the application form for the internship shows up right now on the first click. So this is what happens when it comes to Digital Deepak internship program. So let's go ahead and look at Digital Deepak internship program. And here you can see this is one of the articles that I wrote about Digital Deepak internship program, and this is showing up. And the visitors are not just coming from the webinar, guys. The visitors are coming from search engines directly. So here you can see that these are the different keywords that people are searching for. And you will also be able to go ahead and get a particular page indexed. Like for example, if I just publish this article and if I want to get this page indexed, then I will go ahead and enter this particular URL on the Google Search Console, and it will show me URL is on Google. So if the URL is not on Google, I can click on request indexing and I can go ahead and get it indexed, right? So now Search Console is clear, guys. Just type clear in the chat box if you are clear about the Search Console. So this is how Search Console works. It helps you track the amount of traffic that you are getting from the search engines. Fantastic. So looks like pretty much everybody is clear about Google Search Console. So now I would like to go ahead and show you how I do my email marketing. So let's go ahead and look at my landing page, which is learndigitalmarketing.com. So how many of you here entered my funnel through my landing page, which is learndigitalmarketing.com? How many of you have entered my funnel through my landing page, learndigitalmarketing.com? I think most of you here would have entered my funnel, and right now you are here in this webinar because you entered in this particular landing page, right? So once you build a landing page, then you will be able to go ahead and get people into your email list. So when I told you that I run paid advertising and I send traffic to my landing page, this is what I mean. And to explain how all the paid advertising works, it's beyond the scope of this video, but I will definitely show you one of my paid advertising campaigns, which is Facebook ads. And let me show you how I run my Facebook ads. So how many of you have run Facebook ads before? Just type yes in the chat box if you have run Facebook ads before, and no if you have not run Facebook ads before. So I think most of the people in my internship program would have run Facebook ads as part of the assignments that I gave you, right? You would have done like an experimental campaign to learn how Facebook ads works. Fantastic. So now I will, for people, a lot of people are saying no here who have no idea about Facebook ads. So Facebook ads is very simple. You go ahead and create an ad, and you create an ad image, you create like an image, and you drive leads to it, right? You drive traffic to it. And Facebook will be able to track how many of those people who visited your website have also converted into leads. So here you can see that, I am running a, ad campaign. And here you can see that this is the ad campaign. And this is one of the ad campaigns. So how many of you have seen this ad? Just type me in the chat box if you have seen this ad. All right. So this particular ad directly goes ahead and drives traffic to my landing page, right? So this is the ad that I have created, and people go ahead and click on this ad. And once they click on this ad, they will come to this landing page, and on this landing page, they will enter their name and email ID and enter my funnel. And for every lead, I am paying around 17 cents, right? For every lead, I am paying around 17 cents. So here you can see this month I have generated 1,562 leads at 17 cents. In fact, I will go ahead and increase the budget. I will increase it to $100. And what will happen is that the amount of leads that I will get every day will increase. So right now, what is the amount of leads that I am generating every day? Let's look at yesterday. So yesterday I have generated 233 leads just from Facebook. And let's look at all time. How much traffic I have generated lifetime? 27,000 leads just from this campaign, right? 27,000 leads just from this campaign. But do you want to see how much I have spent on Facebook so far? Let's look at lifetime. And let's look at the total amount I have spent on Facebook so far. Can you see the amount I have spent on Facebook so far, lifetime? So all this ad spend is giving me a return on investment. All this ad spend is giving me a return on investment because every time I go ahead and spend, not 8 lakhs, I think it's more than that. It's more like 80 lakhs, I guess, right? It's more around 80 lakhs. So this is lifetime spent in the past 4 to 5 years is what I have spent this. And I'm able to spend so much money because when I spend money, I get leads. And when I get leads, I go ahead and get a lot of traffic to my email list and landing pages, and then draw a lot of traffic to my website, a lot of people on my webinars, and then a lot of people buy my courses, and I'm getting revenue from the courses. And once I get revenue from the courses, I can go ahead and reinvest in putting back into more and more traffic. And that is how I have built my personal brand. Right. So how many of you now kind of got an idea about Facebook Pixel? So obviously there are, Facebook ads. Obviously, there are a bunch of other things inside Facebook ads, such as campaign managers, ad account settings. You have event managers. You have something called Facebook Pixel. So all this is covered in my Facebook Ads Mastery course. And later in my internship program, people also implement it. But here you can see just an overview of Facebook ads. Now, I would like to show you an overview of Google Ads as well. So how many of you want to have an overview of the Google Ads? Give me one moment. So let me go ahead and show you how my Google ad campaigns work. So I will just show you the Google Data Studio dashboard. So this is my Google Data Studio dashboard. So this dashboard will show me the amount of traffic that I am generating every day from Google Ads. And this is my Google Ads campaigns. So it will show me the conversions. It will show me the cost. It will show me the daily budget versus lead cost. So CTR, average CPC, click conversion rate. So this is how I have built my Google Ads dashboard. And here you can see last month we have generated 30,000 leads and this month we have generated 10,000 leads so far. And if you are going ahead and creating Google Ads for your client as a freelancer, do you think that if you create a report like this, your client will be impressed? Yes. Just type yes in the chat box if you think that your client will be impressed if you create a dashboard like this for ads. You can create this for Facebook ads also. And this is also something that you will be learning, but right now it is beyond the scope of this video to go ahead and explain how this entire thing works, right? So now I would like to go ahead and show you how email marketing works. And I would like to show you my follow-up sequence that I have built. So what is a follow-up sequence? A follow-up sequence is basically sometimes when people sign up, you do like a drip marketing sequence. A drip marketing sequence is where you will keep sending one email, every 1 day or every 2 days, and thereby people will go ahead and keep engaging with your email, right? So this is my ConvertKit account. This is where I do my email marketing. And here you can see that I have 390,000 subscribers. So you are here right now in this webinar because you probably got an email from me. And that is why you are here, right? I sent out an email to you. And look at the amount of emails I have sent so far. How many is it? What is the amount of email I have sent so far? 54.5 million emails. Just type wow in the chat box if you think that that's a lot. I think I will reach 100 million emails soon, right? And this is the amount of email marketing I do. So I do two types of email marketing. One is broadcast email marketing. So whenever I go ahead and want to, send out an email to all the people on my email list, I go ahead and send out an email. And here you can see that I just sent out an email for this particular webinar, right? Webinar started, enter now. We have 1,422 people who clicked on the link and you might have got this email right now, right? You might have got this email right now. And we have got 1,422 clicks. And here I have sent out an email for application for Digital Marketing Club. Then here you can see Digital Marketing Masterclass 9 p.m. This is the email that I sent to my entire email list, right? So right now I am paying a lot for ConvertKit. Let's go ahead and take a look at billing. So what is the amount I am paying right now? I am paying $2,299 a month. That is the amount that I am paying every month. So right now my business has grown. I have a lot of subscribers. I have a lot of revenue. I have 10 employees in my agency, and I make around 30 to 40 lakhs a month in revenue with the course sales and with the Digital Marketing Club and everything. So obviously my business has grown, but when you are just getting started, maybe you will have like 1,000 subscribers, 2,000 subscribers. But even I started with 1,000 subscribers and 2,000 subscribers, right? And you also, and this is unlimited emails. Yes, ConvertKit gives you like unlimited emails. And my email marketing becomes my platform. And my email marketing becomes my platform. And I also have created sequences. I've also created sequences. And once I have created a sequence, then people keep getting emails automatically. So these are the sequences I have created. So let's have a look at one such sequence. So here, let's have a look at digital marketing tools. So once people buy my Digital Marketing Tools Mastery course, I also send follow-up emails to them. So here you can see reports. If I go into reports, these are the kind of open rates that I'm getting for my emails. So have a look at my open rates, guys. And let me know if these open rates are good. First email has got 69%. Second email has got 46%. Third email has got 44%, 43%, 37%. So there are... And open rate is basically if you send out 100 emails, how many people actually open the email is your open rate. So I have actually created like a very, very high quality list. And I go ahead and follow certain methodologies when it comes to email marketing so that the email marketing works really well. So now we have covered, a lot of things in the, high traffic blueprint, right? So what are the things that we have covered in the high traffic blueprint? We have covered a little bit of content marketing, SEO, paid advertising, email marketing, social media is, come on, basic. Social media and sales and conversion is beyond the scope of this video to discuss right now. But social media, what do you do in social media? You go ahead and share content on social media, and that's how social media works, right? You just go ahead and share content on social media. And so without good content and without a good platform, you do not have a social media strategy anyway, right? So that is why creating good content is like extremely important. And once you create good content, you will be able to go ahead and get a lot of traffic to your site. So that, pretty much brings us towards the end of today's presentation about the high traffic blueprint. So how many of you liked today's presentation so far? Let me show me some feedback. Just type amazing or wow or something on the chat box and let me know what did you think about today's session. You kind of got like a bird's eye view on the entire strategy, right? How email marketing works, how SEO works. So I kind of try to, combine all the things together in a cohesive system so that everything starts working in combination with each other, right? Fantastic. So thanks a lot. I see a lot of positive feedback.